Well, the Jam win by 12 points last night. The other game's a 1-point and a 2-point loss for Bakersfield. But head-to-head, Austin averaging 109 points a game against the Jam, and the Jam is scoring 110 points per game. So it should be an entertaining affair once again. Thanks so much for joining us on NBA Futurecast. Rick Hutchins and Matt Kolsky. Austin in their road black with silver and white trim. The Jam, their home whites, navy blue, red, and Vegas gold trim. Your officials, number 52, James Williams, number 39, CJ Washington, and number 41, Cheryl Flores. And we are underway as Austin controls off the tip-off. And here they go in the half-court set, working right to left. Here's Curtis Gerrals. Gerrals guarded by Jeremy Wise, swings it over the left wing. Here's Squeaky Johnson. Trey Johnson picks him up. Squeaky in the corner. Luke Bonner puts up a three and misses early.
And that's the shot Luke Bonner wants. I mean, we've seen it from him before. He sort of fades out to the three-point line and spots up there. And if Holiday is challenging those shots, we'll let him take them.
And now inside the Jam Dance score, but Brian Butch is there for the putback and two.
And that's a great start for Butch. That's what you want to see. Tough rebounding in there against Dwayne Jones and going back up strong with the putback. That more of that from Brian. The more we get on the interior, the better off the Jam are.
2-0 Jam on top. 11:08 to go here in the first. Curtis Gerrals, ball on the deck, kick out. Squeaky Johnson fakes a shot at the right elbow, fans out the Bonner. Now Curtis Gerrals into the paint. Nice distribution. Johnson back to Bonner, and Bonner scores just as the shot clock expires. Nice distribution there. Gerrals to Johnson to Bonner, and we're not at it too early on. Well, after one quarter last night, it was Austin who had the 29-27 lead, but the Jam stormed back to take a 6-point lead in at the break and then never looked back en route to a 12-point win and led by as many as 23 points last night. And now Holiday Aminu will head to the line and get two shots as he misses with the floater. And a personal foul committed by Michael Joyner. Now last night, Michael Joyner got himself in foul trouble, and that really hurt the inside presence of the Toros, Matt.
Yeah, and last night Joyner was the starting power forward really for this team. Tonight he's starting at the three, but it's a tough call to start the game, first of all. He was pretty stationary on that defensive play, but if he gets in foul trouble again, when these Toros go to their bench, there's just not a lot of size there. I mean, McClure is the next guy they bring in as a big, and he's really not a big. So they got to try to keep all three of the big men in the game right now out of foul trouble.
And Aminu makes one of two from the foul line. He has the point. The Jam lead 3-2 early on. 10:28 to go in the first. Squeaky Johnson near the right hash. Finds Bonner between the rings. Hands off to Squeaky Johnson into the paint. Tried to pass into the corner to Gerrals. Ball's batted around. And now off the miss by Johnson. Aminu comes down with a rebound and gives it up to Trey Johnson. Trey Johnson, not one of his best games last night. Looking to get a little redemption. Kick out. Will Daniels tries the three, and that one is too strong, and the rebound claimed by Joyner, and now Gerrals has it across the timeline with 17 on the shot. Finds Bonner. Bounce pass down to Jones. Jones backing in on Butch, and we're going to get a hand check on Brian Butch, his first personal. And Brian Butch, for the most part, able to stay out of foul trouble last night against Jones.
Yeah, he did a good job of that last night. He took a lot of shoulders to the chest, but did a good job of holding his ground and not letting Dwayne Jones bully him, but not getting called for the fouls. And it's going to be important he does that again tonight, because Brian really is the best rebounding presence for this team, and you need that against Dwayne Jones.
Here's Gerrals now. Avoids a double team. Finds Squeaky Johnson, who misses from 17 on the left wing. And the ball is batted out of bounds. Last touch by Bakersfield, so Austin will have possession and a fresh 24 with which to work. And Bonner will inbound.
And that's a hustle play by Bonner there, and that's the other thing he gives you besides three-point shooting is effort out there, and I think that's probably why Quinn Snyder goes with him tonight. And that's something Holiday's got to be careful of, but there gets the steal and out for the breakaway slam.
And it's a long arm of the law, Holiday Aminu that time with the throwdown, and 3 points for Holiday. Jam on top, and now spinning in the lane is Jones, and we've got another foul, and this time it's going to be Aminu, and he's not sure why, but he'll get his first personal, team foul number two, as Dwayne Jones heads to the foul line for two shots.
And I think you can file that under turnabout as fair play based on the call against Joyner the other way. pretty much the same situation where Holiday, kind of straight but a little angled, reached down with the arms a little bit. I will say, though, Dwayne Jones managed to spin around an alarming number of times without walking on that play.
Well, last night, Dwayne Jones was 10 of 18 from the charity stripe. He knocks down the first one, and it is a 5-3 lead for Bakersfield. Jones sets, releases, and drops that one in as well.
I'll tell you what, for a guy with no spin on his shot, he hits free throws at a pretty impressive clip.
2 for 2 for Jones. He has two. Jam up by one with 9:05 to go in the first. And a raucous crowd here at the event center on a Saturday night. Wise, Trey Johnson, high post left side. He'll release and miss from 19. And Dwayne Jones claims the rebound and hands off to Curtis Gerald.
Well, Trey's going to be looking for that all night, though, because we talked about this last night as well. He can shoot right over the top of Squeaky Johnson, and he should continue to look for that shot.
Johnson out, Gerald. Gerald's quiet here in the early going, 4 minutes in. Looking for somewhere to go. Wise is all over him. Now Gerald penetrates, throws it up, and a beautiful shot off the window.
My goodness, he is tough and took a lot of contact, absorbed it, hung in the air, and finished with the right hand. That's a really nice-looking play by Curtis Gerald.
2 for Gerald. Brian Butch tries the triple. Misses. Aminu the rebound. Put it up and in. Beautiful shot by Aminu high off the glass.
Great touch by Holiday, reaching far to his right and sort of spinning it off the top of the backboard. That's a tough layup to make.
And now Joyner has it. Jam up by one. 8:02 to go. Squeaky penetrates. Kick out Bonner for three. That one is offline, and Aminu his second rebound. Wise pushing it up the floor to Will Daniels. Up with the left hand. What a shot!
And Will, once again, just showing how good he is at taking contact around the rim and finishing. And he's either going up for a dunk on top of you, or he's going to go up to absorb that contact. And he's as good as anyone at hanging in the air after he takes that hit and finishing a layup.
Great body control to switch to the left hand in midair, falling back. And Will Daniels, his first two of the contest, 23 last night. And the free throw on the way is off the mark. So 9-6 jam. Daniels has two. Gerald's with it as he crosses center court. Plenty of time on the shot clock.
And 15. Back to a small lineup for Austin as that time Squeaky Johnson slipped away. But really a three-guard offense here with Joyner sliding over to defend Bush at the four spot.
And Brian Butch tries the 18-footer, miss, but what an athletic rebound by Will Daniels using his great wingspan.
And that's your problem with having Lewis Clinch trying to box out and defend against Will Daniels. He's just too small.
And then a little Sharon the Sugar, and Holiday Aminu throws down on a nice feed from Will Daniels. And Quinn Snyder wants to discuss this deficit of three. 11-8, Bakersfield on top. We're going to keep it here, because it's just a quick 20 to stop the jam momentum with 7:14 to go.
I'll tell you what, the way Quinn Snyder looks right now, I'm thinking he wishes he had 10 guys so he could take all five of the dudes in the game and put them on the bench right now. And you could see him getting steamed at the end of last night's game, and watching the way the Toros played on these last couple defensive possessions seems to have got him awfully hot again. And it's understandable. That time, you end up leaving 6'10" Holiday Aminu wide open right in front of the rim. That's just an inexcusable defensive lapse. Failure to rotate after an offensive rebound by the jam. So right now, Austin, they're sort of at a breaking point. The roster's short. They've lost a couple guys to the NBA. They've had an injury or two. And this is a team that's going through a lot of the struggles that the jam experienced in the first half of the season. And right now, Quinn Snyder's just not satisfied with the effort that the remainder of this team is giving him.
Austin with the ball in the half-court set. Jones has it. He'll give it up to Gerald's with 12 on the shot clock. Austin trails by three with 7 minutes. Gerald's pull-up 18-footer and drops it in. Curtis Gerald's with four, and the jam lead is one. Now Trey Johnson the other way. Gerald's will be on him. Joyner comes out to help. Inside to Brian Butch, he'll be fouled and he'll get two shots.
And that's a mismatch there. I mean, this is the problem, and now McClure will come back in, probably for Joyner, and he's going to have to match up against Brian Butch. And this is where we've talked about it. Brian can really go inside and do some damage. If he's got, and Joyner just got himself a technical foul as well. complaining about the foul call. And so now, boy, you can see the frustration on the faces of this whole Austin team. And as McClure tries to come in and guard Butch, I mean, you can see just watching them. And when they're next to each other, it'll stand out even more. Brian's just a lot bigger than David McClure. I mean, that's just an incredibly tough matchup for him. And if you put Dwayne Jones on Butch, Alade Aminu will have a field day against David McClure. So they just, right now, the Toros are struggling to find the bodies to handle the Bakersfield bigs.
Well, Jeremy Y sinks the technical. Michael Joyner heads to the bench with two fouls. Brian Butch, second free throw on the way, and his free throw shooting continues to be a problem. He makes the second one. Butch with 3 points, and the Jam lead is three here early on. So far in the game, Alde Aminu with 7 points and three rebounds to lead all scorers. And several players for Austin have 2 points. Curtis Gerald's has four. And a foul is on Jeremy Wise, his first personal third team foul, so it evens team fouls up at three. And David McClure, who's checked in for Austin at 6'6", 206 from Duke University, is in the game, along with Jones and Lewis Clinch out of Georgia Tech at 6'3". And now we've got an offensive foul moving screen on Dwayne Jones, and Jeremy Wise is a bit shaken there.
And I'm not sure what might have happened, but that almost looked like a message foul from Dwayne Jones. He really turned himself right into the smaller Jeremy Wise on that play.
Johnson, Butch, Wise, Aminu, and Will Daniels, the same starting five on the floor for the Jam here. Inside, a high post left side, Brian Butch, beautiful cut, Will Daniels, an easy finish.
And that's the same thing, and Quinn Snyder is furious right now. That's the same play on the other side. This time, Will Daniels instead of Alade Aminu getting a wide open look, and now Jeremy Wise steals the pass from Curtis Gerald.
Here comes Wise to the trailer. Butch, Lewis Clinch will be whistled on the foul, and Brian Butch will head back to the line for two more shots.
Austin fouls on number 15, Lewis Clinch.
And, you know, I don't want to say I feel sorry for them, because certainly no one was feeling sorry for the Jam in the first half of the season when, you know, they lose Robert Swift and so many injuries and roster turnover. But when you look at this Austin Toros roster right now, and you see Quinn Snyder struggling to find the combination of guys that can match up, and it just seems like, you know, now it's Dominique Coleman coming in for Lewis Clinch. But with Gerald's, Coleman, and Johnson all out there at the same time, really, size-wise, there's only one player on the Jam floor that any of them can match up with size-wise, and that's Jeremy Wise, who's quicker than all three of them. So just defensively, they have really tough matchups here.
Here's McClure, dribble penetration. Ball's knocked out of bounds, and Will Daniels is pleading his case, and official Cheryl Flores goes over
Will saying that
Washington and Williams to discuss the issue.
Yeah, Will is saying that Lewis Clinch reached out from the bench and grabbed that ball while it was still in play, kept him from having a chance to save it, and the referees agree.
Well, we got an official timeout on the floor. Jam lead Austin 17-10, and we'll step aside on NBA.com/VLEAGUE.